One of the big redesigns of the Android 15 update is the new volume panel. This update finally brings Material U elements to this area of the operating system, and today I can show you an application that will bring this updated design to any device running Android 9 or higher. But before we get to that, we have a word from today's sponsor. PlayStoreSales.com is a website specifically made for highlighting Android apps and games that are currently on sale. It has sections for app sales and game sales, so if you are only interested in apps, for example, then you will only see those. Be sure to check out the website www.playstoresales.com, and don't forget to add a shortcut to your home screen either. That way, it will act like an application and you'll always have it bookmarked right on your home screen. Now back to today's guide. The new update to the volume panel has had a rocky introduction. Some people are happy with the new look, as it makes the volume bars easy to interface with. Others, though, seem to be less excited about it, as they feel the volume bars are too large for their liking. So let me show you the application that can update your volume panel to the new look, and let me know what you think about it. We do this by first downloading the Precise Volume application from the Google Play Store. The app is free to download, but to use the Android 15 theme, you must purchase the Pro version within the app. So once it has been installed, we're going to go ahead and open it up and then dive into the settings area. Then from here, we want to look for the volume button override option. And here you can see this is going to be disabled by default. We can enable it, and it's going to ask us to grant the overlay permission so that it can display over other apps. And this is required in order for the updated volume panel to work while you're inside other apps. Now we're going to go back to the app, enable it again, and this time it's talking about accessibility permission. And this is required so that we're able to control the volume with this app using our volume hardware buttons. So when this appears, we're going to tap the allow button. Then from here, we go to installed apps, precise volume, and enable the accessibility option from here. It's going to confirm if you want to allow. So we allow again. And then again, we go back to the application to make sure that it is now been enabled. With the Precise Volume application set up, we can adjust the volume using the hardware buttons, and you see it has the new design here. But from here, we can then tap on the three-dot menu icon to see the fully updated design. By default, the volume panel will be displayed in a compact state, but this can be expanded with the tap of the up arrow button right there. Sadly, we don't have the media output switcher button here, like we do with the Android 15 update. But it does give us a couple of buttons that introduce us to some features of the Precise Volume application itself. And I'll do a separate video about this app so that I can highlight all of those features. Since this video is just about showing you how to get that redesigned volume panel, this is where I'll end things today. But I would like to hear what you think of this new redesign. Are you happy that it finally has Material U elements? And do you like the look of the wider sliders? Let me know your thoughts down in the comments section below.